but I would like to begin
This
this
call is now being
today's
recorded.
session with an activity. I give you the link of a Padlet in the chat window, and I would like to know what comes to your mind when you first hear about the word AI. So I'm putting the link of a Padlet in the chat window. I hope it is accessible to all. Let me know if there is any difficulty, and I'm waiting to see your opinions. And from there, I'll build on. This will give me an understanding. What is your present thought about AI? So thank you for pouring in your responses. Keep adding them. We will take 1 or 2 minutes more by the time you are putting in your responses. Let me just share my screen and I will show you what is coming up. So let us see each other's perspectives also. Okay, so here we are. So beautiful responses. Upcoming field, humanoids, machine, the ability to think and act like humans. Very, very valid answers that are coming up. So let that continue to come. Creative thinking, doing extraordinary things, intelligent machines, cognitive thinking. So very, very valid answers that you people are putting in. I see a lot of people writing, so I'll just wait on this slide for 1 more minute. Need of R for each of us, right? Very valid point. Okay, so those who are typing, please continue to type. I'll come back to this slide in another 5 minutes and we'll see what are the responses here. So we are having this session today, leveraging AI for increasing productivity and engagement. When I see productivity, it means how we can make our work more easier by leveraging AI. So the topic has some deep meaning here. It's not that just for keeping a catchy topic, we have kept it. So when AI, people started to work on AI, the whole idea was that machine should be able to do all the mundane jobs for which we humans waste a lot of our energy. And we save time and energy to do creative and innovative stuff. With that thought, only 5, 7 years back, we saw a lot of revolution in terms of, fully automatic washing machines, microwaves coming into place, then our smart refrigerators coming into place. So the idea was these are also kind of small robots, those autonomous machines, which would help us do our daily task and we can, rely on the machines. So these machines work with minimal human intervention and we can leverage that spare time that we are getting. So if our dishwasher is doing washing my dishes while I'm taking this session, I'm productively utilizing my time to empower few educators while the machine is doing my job. So I'm saving some time and utilizing it for some creative work. So that is what the meaning of productivity, but that has gone beyond bounds and leaps nowadays. Nowadays, technology is not only AI, is not only about having smart machines at home. We used to see in old TV serials where there were robots and they would serve guest tea, coffee, they would clean the house. So that is definitely a practice which is going on very frequently in abroad and here in India also in some of the countries. We have robots which clean our houses. So recently Eureka Forbes has also launched a machine, that robot, you give it direction, you fix it one time, you tell him the path one time that how to start the cleaning drive. Next morning, you don't have to train it. It will automatically follow the path you showed him. It will do the mopping exactly the way you will explain the robot. So those things are very common. So productivity is, yes, increasing. And when I say engagement, so I'm going to talk about these two terms, not from a common man perspective, more from the perspective of we educators. Definitely, we all are common man and we also do real life work like any other person. But considering that we educators are future builders and we need to equip our students with future ready skills. So I will be giving examples more from the perspective of teachers and students interaction and how productivity there and engagement there can be increased. Moving on, at the end of this session, I would try to explain you the way artificial intelligence works, how it impacts the result of our actions in digital space based on our digital footprint. We will explore some of the ways to leverage artificial intelligence in our classroom and increase our productivity as a teacher. And I will also try to give you some tools to increase engagement and enhance creativity and critical thinking. So basically, as an AI trainer, I have this program, which is 9-day long program to say. So it's a 9-10 hour long program, but it's a small capsule what we are offering you today. And we are giving you glimpses of what educators can do. So otherwise, you know, one can spend hours doing exploring tools. And for the, I just want to tell teachers, if they really want to go beyond and explore, CBSE has given beautiful manual on their website for AI integration into all subjects. So there are manuals for integration into mathematics, social sciences, sciences. So you can explore those beautiful manuals. There are some tools which CBSE has picked up for integrating AI into curriculum. And those manuals uses those tools, and most of those tools, or rather all of those tools, are free and open source. So you can explore those tools. I will showcase some of them today. Now, moving ahead, we were on this activity. Let me just have a link once again if there are some more thoughts. So the future, definitely. Google Maps have made driving so easy, perfect. I am somebody who forgets the, you know, बहुत जल्दी मुझे रास्ते भूल जाते हैं. फॉर मी गूगल मैप इज रियली अ सेवियर. अदरवाइज आई विल एंड अप वेस्टिंग लॉट ऑफ फ्यूल व्हिच इज सो कॉस्टली नाउअडेज. सो आई एम अ ग्रेट फैन ऑफ गूगल मैप्स. समथिंग ह्यूमंस कैन डिपेंड ऑन. ह्यूमनॉइड मशीन्स फैंटास्टिक. सो ऑल लवली रिस्पॉन्सेज. बिफोर वी मूव अहेड, वन मोर लिटिल एक्टिविटी. व्हाट आर सम ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट कंप्यूटर कैन डू बेटर देन ह्यूमन बीइंग? Please share your answers in the chat window. I'm keeping an eye on the chat window. Mention 2-3 things where you feel computers can do better than humans. So I am just moving to the chat window to see your responses. A few things, okay. Calculations, complex calculations. They don't feel tired, redundant work. Excellent, excellent. Fast and correct. So I feel everybody is a computer teacher in a room, because this is class 2-3 syllabus, chapter number 2, what machines do better than humans. Sending reminders, repetitive task, accuracy, perfect. Storage is good. Excellent. So all answers, I'm loving your answers and all are correct. The next thought, what are some of the things that humans can do better than computers? What are some of the things that we humans can do better than computers? IQ, emotional quotient, right? Things logically, emotions, decision-making, explanation of concept, compassionate, empathy. Absolutely. I think I am today dealing with an absolutely intelligent and intellect audience. All perfect answers are coming. Or maybe, I don't know who is your Google Baba or this is real brain, but absolutely perfect answers. I don't have to add anything. You are giving so perfect answers. So yes, ability to decide is take decision, show empathy, have emotions, make right decisions. Then based on situation, change your decision. These are certain things which we all can do better than computers. Now, can you recall this image? What are the thoughts that come to your mind when you see this image? What is this image? Can audience unmute themselves, sir? Okay, if they do not have right to unmute, then please feel free to put in the chat window.
Yeah, it's Chacha Chaudhary and Sabu.
Okay.
Chacha
Chaudhary
ka dimag computer se bhi tej hai.
They can unmute themselves.
Okay. And what is this magazine that where they both were characters? Anybody remember the name of the magazine, the comic where they were
Diamond Comics.
Diamond Comics. Excellent. So go down the memory lane and think that in the magazine, Sabu was shown as one of the powerful man. And, you know, Chacha Chaudhary was one of the brainy man. But Sabu would do disasters if he's not well guided by Chacha Chaudhary. And though Chacha Chaudhary was very smart, had all the you know, brain to do something, but he did not have that physical power to do that. So he wanted to give his idea to Sabu and Sabu would implement that. So bina Chacha Chaudhary ke Sabu ka itna powerful hona bhi was not of that great help. Now see this in this perspective. So wise and smart is we humans and machines are dumb giants. And we give them brain to, you know, think like us. So we are giving them that power. So be rest assured that we humans are indispensable. Nobody can replace us. No AI will take away our job. So people are saying that AIs are taking away job. Forget about that. Rather, AI would create more opportunities for we people. It's just that the nature of job will, you know, vanish. If I just now open and do a Google search, you can do it at your end. Jobs of 2025, predicted jobs, you will see half of the jobs are AI based, AI architect, AI researcher, AI design thinker, AI moderator, AI supervisor, AI engineer. So there are a lot of jobs that are coming up. And a survey says that in 2025, 4% jobs will increase. There is no decrease. It's just that the skill set which was required is changing. एक जमाना था जब हम बच्चों को वर्ड एक्सेल पावर पॉइंट पढ़ाते थे कि बेटा ऐसे सेलेक्ट करो एंड देन यू इंक्रीज द फॉन्ट साइज एंड देन यू चेंज द कलर दैट आई डोंट नीड टू टीच इवन टुडे बाय फोर ईयर चाइल्ड दे विल जस्ट ओपन द कंप्यूटर और फोन दे विल सेलेक्ट विद माउस एंड दे विल क्लिक टू बटन्स एंड इट इज डन नो नीड टू टीच दिस जनरेशन दैट हाउ टू इंक्रीज द फॉन्ट साइज और हाउ टू टाइप दे नो इट दे आर डिजिटल नेटिव्स So the skill set which were 5 years back required, now they are absolutely changing. Jobs are not getting less. It's just that the skills required to get the jobs are changing. And that is where we have to act together. And this is where the AI is coming in a big picture. Be very mindful of the situation 5 years down the line. NEP and CBSE is doing a lot of work. They have CBSE website already have manuals on data sciences, artificial intelligence. Why they are so, you know, progressive and thoughtful about it? Because they know these are the skills that the future generation would require. So machines are dependent on we humans. We can't be just the consumer of technology. Our children have to be producer of technology. They must understand what AI is, how AI can be used to solve many real world problems. So that is where the beauty of AI comes in. Let's move ahead. So in a nutshell, I would like to say that AI is the ability of a machine to mimic human behavior. Mimic human behavior, replicate human behavior. So it cannot replicate our behavior to 100%, but it is its little limited capability to extent we code it in that spectrum of coding. Jitna aap usko code karenge, uske according it can mimic certain human behaviors. So that is AI. Even though we say that AI is in its infancy stage in our country, we are already surrounded by so much AI. Hum abhi bolte hain ki India mein to abhi AI mein kaam hona shuru hua hai. And we are into very premature stage. AI will come up in big way in 5 years down the line. But then also we are absolutely surrounded by nowadays with AI. Let's talk about AI in our mailbox. In our mailbox, spam mails goes to different folders. We have, you know, primary, we have updates, we have promotions, we have socials, many folders. So bifurcation of mails, smart compose and reply features, AI give us automatic prompt ki aapko iska response aise dena chahiye. Thank you for your mail. Or sure, we'll let you know in a while. Some small prompters come at the bottom. It means AI is able to read the content what has come in mail and is able to propose us the probable response that we can give to the person. Text prediction while writing the emails, auto reply detection, all that is due to AI. So see on my screen, if suppose somebody is typing, I am attaching a document to this mail, kindly take. Aapne TA type kiya hai, automatically AI suggesting take a look. So all these suggestions come from AI. On the next screen, you say, it was nice to hear from you after such a long time. I'm attaching a document, but there is no attachment. So AI prompts. It seems like you forgot to attach a file. You wrote in the message, I'm attaching a file, but there is no file. You want to send it anyway. So AI is helping you remember that you forgot to attach the file. Now, this ability of AI to read, you know, your messages and understand the languages is called natural language processing. NLP is an important domain of AI that it understand natural languages, which is being used here. Now, let's come to some real life examples. Amazon is able to suggest most relevant products for solving a complicated algorithm. You know, AI is being used at Amazon in a big way. And Amazon itself says that 35% of its sales has gone up from the time it has included AI algorithms into its business model. Now, how do they come to know? So in the previous slide, it was written, they suggest this most relevant product and they have algorithm about it. For other than Amazon also, you go on Google and you know, you search about, let's say, a pair of shoes. You go to 10 sites, you search for shoes, or ladies go and search for kurtis. Now, you maybe are searching on, you know, websites like Myntra or websites like whatever our e-commerce website or on Amazon. But even if you go to other sites, so yesterday night I was searching about in my kitchen, I wanted a dispenser where I can put this cellophane and the, you know, wraps and all. So, or kitchen tissue paper and all. So I was searching it on Amazon. And this morning when I was looking on Java for School and academic website, the ad which was coming on the right bottom of the screen, that was related to all those cellophane dispensers and all, which I was looking last night. So it actually, the AI has become so strong based on our digital footprint. It analyzes our shopping patterns, our styles, and it gives us ads on the website related to our interest. Ek cheez aap aur note kijiyega. If suppose you are buying a product online, so you are searching it and you are searching it and you have purchased it online. The moment you will purchase it, your deal is closed. You will see suddenly aapko us cheez ke ad aane band ho jayenge. But if you have searched in the online space or kharida aapne jaake offline, to AI ko aapko pata nahi chalega ki aap shopping kar chuke hain. You were just searching online. Wo fir bhi aapko ads deti rahegi. So that is how the computer, you know, keep track of your digital footprint. So digital footprint is a term which is used to address all our activities that we do in the online space. Whatever websites we search, the kind of comments we post. Digital footprint ka ek aur impact hai. If suppose you go on Facebook and you are liking all the posts related, or you are watching all the reels related to khana banane se related, or related to, you know, mehndi designs, or related to wedding attires. So you would see that all your advertisement will turn into your advertisement of your interest. You will not see anything else other than 3-4 searches which you prominently do. They will come on top. So that is where AI comes into picture, and it is really impacting our actions in the digital space. Now I'll show you just one little video. Even Amazon is using, you know, AI to track its workers' social distancing in the office. Though they have very minimal staff, it's all robots. But whatever staff they have, they use cameras and AI-enabled features to track workers' distancing, whether they are following the norms of social distancing or not. Now, see this Amazon office. It's absolutely human-free. There are all robots packing, you know, sending to the required warehouse and a specific section, putting the labels for dispatch. Everything is happening through robots. So it's all through machines. Now, this concept where, you know, before we place order to Amazon, Amazon actually sends out the orders for shipping and they purchase from wherever they buy. So they place order to their dealers. This is called anticipatory shipping. And they do anticipatory shipping. Wo pehle se utna saman procure kar lete hain aur transit mein dal dete hain, because they know these orders are likely to come. And how do they know? Based on our pattern of shopping with them. Now just see this little video, and sir, let me know if the voice is not audible.
4 years ago.
I hope the audio is coming.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
We started to wonder, what would shopping look like if you could walk into a store, grab what you want, and just go? What if we could weave the most advanced machine learning, computer vision, and AI into the very fabric of a store so you never have to wait in line? No lines, no checkouts, no registers. Welcome to Amazon Go. Use the Amazon Go app to enter. Then put away your phone and start shopping. It's really that simple. Take whatever you like. Anything you pick up is automatically added to your virtual cart. If you change your mind about that cupcake, just put it back. Our technology will update your virtual cart automatically. So, how does it work? We used computer vision, deep learning algorithms, and sensor fusion, much like you'd find in self-driving cars. We call it Just Walk Out technology. Once you've got everything you want, you can just go. When you leave, our Just Walk Out technology adds up your virtual cart and charges your Amazon account. Your receipt is sent straight to the app, and you can keep going. Amazon Go. No lines, no checkout. No, seriously.
So, this is not something which we say is futuristic. There are already 2 stores like this in Bangalore, and there are many more in abroad. So this is not something which is going to come. It is already there. So that is how AI is impacted. How many of you have ever taken participation on Facebook in the little prompters that come you? Aap pichle janam mein kya the? Ya aapki shakal kisse milti hai? Aur ya fir aap कौन से हीरो हीरोइन से मिलते हैं? हैव यू एवर सीन दीस काइंड ऑफ एड्स? हैव यू एवर सीन दीस काइंड्स ऑफ एड्स?
यस मैम.
एंड हैव यू पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दोस?
यस,
मोस्ट ऑफ अस, यू नो, वी एंड अप डूइंग. सो अब हम सबको एक से एड भी नहीं आते हैं. आप कभी नोट कीजिएगा, अगर कोई अपनी मम्मी के साथ बहुत सारी फोटो डालता है और फेसबुक को पता चल जाता है कि इसका मम्मी के साथ बहुत प्यार है, तो उसको मम्मी के जैसे एड आते हैं कि लाइक पिछले जन्म में आप किन के बेटे थे, या पिछले जन्म में आपकी मदर क्या थी, या आपकी मम्मी किस बच्चे को सबसे ज्यादा प्यार करती हैं. मतलब उनको उस तरह के ऐड आएंगे. कोई बहुत हस्बैंड वाली फोटो डालते हैं तो उनको उनके हस्बैंड और उनके बारे में ऐड आते हैं. ये सब भी एआई कैसे प्रेडिक्ट करता है, बेस्ड ऑन हम किस तरह की पोस्ट डालते हैं. और एड भी हमें उसी तरह के आते हैं, और ये वाले ट्रेलर्स भी. अब इनका फेसबुक को क्या फायदा है जब आप ऐसे एड्स देखते हैं? देयर कैप्शंस आर वेरी कैची. मैं इतना पढ़े लिखे होने के बाद भी और कंप्यूटर टीचर होने के बाद भी मैंने भी कम से कम 10 एड्स में पार्टिसिपेट किया होगा, बिकॉज उनके कैप्शन इतने कैची होते हैं. आपकी शक्ल किस हीरोइन से मिलती है? भाई मुझे भी जानना है कि मेरी शक्ल किसी हीरोइन से भी मिल सकती है. सो यू गेट यू नो इंट्यूटिव टूवर्ड्स इट, और आप ना चाहते हुए भी क्लिक कर देते हैं और आप देखते हैं. एंड देन दे टेल यू शेयर देयर डेटा ऑन फेसबुक, ताकि और लोग भी उसको देखकर उसकी तरफ अट्रैक्ट हो. एंड सेकेंडली दे आस्क यू टू साइन इन. सो व्हेन दे आस्क यू टू साइन इन, दे आर बेसिकली थर्ड पार्टी यू नो पीपल टू होम फेसबुक इनवाइट्स फॉर एडवर्टाइजमेंट. फेसबुक ने ये कहा कि जितने भी लोग फेसबुक पे एड देते हैं, अब अगर यू एंड अप पेइंग गिविंग योर डेटा टू अदर्स, वी आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल. इट इज इन देयर पॉलिसी. अब वो जो एड है वो फेसबुक ने नहीं बनाया है, उन्होंने सिर्फ उसको परमिशन दिया है पैसे लेके वहां एड डिस्प्ले करने का. नाउ इफ वी क्लिक ऑन एंड देन इट आस्क्स अस टू साइन इन विद गूगल और साइन अस विद फेसबुक, देन वी आर गिविंग आवर पर्सनल डेटा टू देम, एंड देन दीज पीपल लीक आवर डेटा. सो दीज पीपल नीड आवर डेटा फॉर देयर बिजनेस, सो वी एंड अप गिविंग आवर डेटा आवरसेल्फ, एंड देन वी रियलाइज दैट आवर मेल बॉक्स इज फुल ऑफ स्पैम, एंड देन वी ब्लेम दीज कंपनीज दैट दे डोंट हैव स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉलिसीज. They sell our data. So ultimately, we are also hugely responsible for these kind of actions, because of our digital footprint, we sign up into so many third-party apps and we do that. My suggestion here is, during the pandemic also, we have tried to learn so many new technology, and every app asks us to sign in using Gmail. I would suggest you just make a Gmail app for third-party apps. You can write it that, you know, Sonia@thirdparty, whatever, Sonia@thirdpartyapp@gmail.com. सो मेक एन ईमेल लाइक दैट एंड जहां पर भी आपको किसी भी थर्ड पार्टी ऐप में साइन करना है पिक अप दैट जीमेल अकाउंट एंड व्हेन यू क्रिएट दैट अकाउंट व्हाटएवर पर्सनल इन्फॉर्मेशन यू गिव मेक श्योर दैट्स नॉट रियल इन्फॉर्मेशन सो दैट यू आर ऑन द सेफर साइड एंड योर पर्सनल इन्फॉर्मेशन इज नॉट रिवील्ड टू सो मेनी थर्ड पार्टी ऐप वेंडर्स दैट्स जस्ट अ सजेशन वी कैन ऑलवेज डू दैट क्रिएट एन अकाउंट फॉर दैट पर्पज ओनली. Now, moving ahead, for an average active user, so I'll just give you one example. I have, you know, my relatives belongs to one religious cult. So they invited me to join. I joined that cult's Facebook group and I liked one of their posts. Now, whatever, there are 10, 20 groups related to that on Facebook. Now, my Facebook is full of the, you know, post of that kind of from that religious cult. So what I'm trying to say, our one like even make a lot of difference in our action. AI has become so strong that it can predict our level of intelligence. It can predict our religion. It can predict our mental health and relationship status by sentiment analysis. I'll show you an AI in 5 minutes from now, which can do sentiment analysis also. So it can, you know, guess our location, it can guess our friend list, our profile, our school, college, workplace. With face, they can recognize you with better accuracy than humans in the entire Facebook network. This is also I myself observed. So to great extent, my elder son looks like my husband. And whenever bechara, he posts some pictures, so his dad posts some pictures, which he rarely does. So he says that AI shows me that picture and he says, it seems you are in this picture. Would you like to tag yourself? Aur wo sari pictures uske dad ki hoti hai. So he says that, you know, AI matches both of us. And whenever I post, AI gives a prompt to him to tag. And whenever he posts, AI gives a tag to me. Ki that you would you like to tag yourself? So even kuch rishtedaron ko bhi nahi itna samajh mein aata hoga ki ye dono ek se dikh rahe hain. Wo bolte honge thoda bahut dikh rahe hain. Lekin AI ko pehle pata chalta hai that these two humans look alike. Identify and remove inappropriate content. Ab hum log bahut baar bolte hain that, you know, we saw that this tweet was up 4 o'clock. There was this tweet for PM Modi and now it's removed. And there was some content on Facebook about this religion. Ab wo post mili nahi rahi, it got disappeared. So how it happens, some inappropriate content get removed. So they're not humans. It is not humanly possible that there are million of users of these social media and they would make a team to sit there and pay them just for this purpose ki wahan baithkar aap dekhiye kaun appropriate post kar raha hai kaun inappropriate usko hataiye. This is not humanly possible. There are bots, there are AI enabled applications which have some filter words. If you use any that word in your post, then it comes into scrutiny, then it is passed to a human moderator. So on average on Facebook, AI may pick up 100, 200 posts and pass it to a human moderator, which skim through the post. And if it is really has to do with some politician, some big, religious cult or something, if it has to be removed, then the person take appropriate approvals and then it is removed. So for all this also, AI is used to a great extent. If there will be no bots and if there will be no AI involved in this process of filtering, then though there will be, you know, Facebook will require a man task of 20 to 30 people sitting just for this purpose and give them salary to read this, which is not humanly possible. So AI use there also. YouTube filter out our comments based on sentiment analysis. That is also done by AI. AI is used in medical fields, agriculture to a great extent. We can, you know, make precision about what kind of crop is going to happen, what is the level of water pollution, what is the status of marine life. So marine sea ice monitoring, maritime monitoring, all of this is done through AI. We have self-driving cars coming through AI, which are controlled by AI. So this is what is recently happening. I give you the link of this particular video. It's a long video, but I can just show some glimpses. How come China so quickly, you know, came out of pandemic? Because they used AI to a great extent. So I'll show some of the glimpses of this video.
Our son Vihan, he's good at studies, but one thing that he always struggled with was speaking.
There's been a lot of talk about China's high-tech fight against coronavirus, robots delivering food in hospitals, facial recognition cameras taking people's temperatures, and drones enforcing lockdowns and quarantines. But what about the tech we can't see? China's data surveillance system is used to track citizens on and offline. During the pandemic, the mass surveillance network has taken the Communist Party decades to build. They've faced near constant criticism around the world.
In
trying to get a grip on COVID-19, many countries are looking to the model for answers. Here's how they're doing it in South Korea.
They're using a form to locate where you are, and then they send you to where you are near, where.
So I will give the link of this in the interest of time in the chat window. You can, you know, watch it at your leisure. I'll move ahead and show some of the beautiful aspects of AI ahead. And I'm putting the link of it in the chat window. Those who wish to see, you can. So I see a raise of hand from Anjali ma'am. Ma'am, would you like to ask a question?
Ma'am, you were talking about making a Gmail account with a third party, whatever that thing you say that. So I have a question that in Gmail, we cannot make any account without giving our
phone number
in information, you know. They will ask either a small another email to verify your this particular email or the phone number.
And then ma'am, the phone number and go by phone number. Just give the phone number. Don't give anything else. If not your correct date of birth. And don't do another email verification. Number, I agree. One number you have to give. So I usually, you know, when I started to take so many sessions in the pandemic, I had to sign in into so many apps like Nearpod, Edpuzzle. So I made a separate account because, you know, then these people send you so many promotional mails also. So your actual mailbag box gets cluttered with so many mails. So it's better you keep it separate in a separate mailbox.
But your phone number and the email ID are optional nowadays in Gmail.
Yeah.
These are optional.
Yeah.
In Gmail.
Any one official thing you have to give. Any one of these you have to give. Either a backup email or a phone number to retrieve your code if you forget your password.
Okay. But I think that phone numbers are actually attached with your Aadhaar card or PAN card or the bank accounts. So giving a phone number becomes again a very difficult thing, or, you know, that is what I think. Well,
agreed.
I'll again try.
So agreed, ma'am. But see, I tried this. It helps me in two ways. One thing is that my actual mailbox is not spammed with the promotional mail of these third party apps. Second thing, when you sign up to a mail or an app, if, for example, you want to disconnect that app at any point of time, so once you have learned and you don't want to have that account active or you don't want to use, you can go and disconnect your account. And thirdly, when your phone number is connected to others, like you said, Aadhaar, and even to your bank accounts, they have their policy that they will not disclose their information. So if somebody through your phone number try to search your Aadhaar number details, very, very difficult, because Government of India also have certain policies that you can't find this information based on one of the information which somebody has given in the Aadhaar, unless we have not done some KYC updation and all through our phone. So yes, you are right in saying that there are challenges there also, but whatever best wiser we can act, we can try doing that. Now, AI is greatly used in search engine, shopping recommendation, our digital assistants like AI, Alexa, Siri, you know, everywhere AI is used. I'm not sure how many of you are using Alexa at home. Do you know that Alexa is listening to us 24/7? Does that scare you in any way? Because it is listening to us and it is learning from our behaviors. So I have a suggestion here also. If you want that your AI should help you with quick commands. For example, if I say that, you know, Alexa, play Ganesh Aarti. So you, Alexa, shut down. So my Alexa heard my instruction and she started. So I'm saying, if, for example, if I say her that, you know, some quick commands, that Alexa book a ticket or Alexa do this, so it will keep on, you know, doing those commands. And if at the end of the day I say, Alexa, forget everything that I say you, then what is happening, that I am erasing my data every day and I'm not letting that reinforced machine learning to happen. So that is one flip point, because if there are 10 Ganesh Aartis available out there and I train it that do play this one only for me. So I trained it, it understood next time when I say that, do that, it will play the correct Aarti. But if I say at the end of the day, forget everything that I say, whatever I trained it, it has forgotten that. So that is the negative side of it. But if I don't want it to hear our conversation the entire day, or, you know, I feel that it can be threatening because my entire data is going somewhere and there will be people out where the backup will be taken on server, somebody can listen our important conversations, then at the end of the day, we can just say, Alexa, forget everything I told you today. So it will ask you, are you sure?
I don't know that one.
Alexa, forget everything I told you. Then it would ask you, are you sure you want to forget everything? Then you say yes. And then it will wipe out its old data. So whatever backup it would have taken, it will forget that. So we can have these little things where we can act a little smarter and let technology not overrule us. And we can ensure that our data is in safe things. And same thing I told you about your digital footprints also. So make wiser decision. Don't click on any link that come your way online. And you can clear your histories frequently, clear cookies, so that most of your data is not going to other hands. Now, in a nutshell, AI is all about computer vision, data, and natural language processing. Now, just to give you an example, when I say computer vision, you take your phone, open Google Lens, click, take it near a piece of furniture, or take it near a plant, and click that and click on search. So Google does image search and find out all the information related to that product. So suppose you went to a hotel, वहाँ एक side table पड़ा था, आपको बहुत अच्छा लग रहा था, you want to see from where this person must have procured it, if it is of a specific brand, आप उसका photo लीजिए, you click on image search, then you will get the exact store where those have been procured. Same, you know, teachers can use it to teach plants and about plants and animals. You can say that, go around, see 5 unknown plants to you, take a picture, do image search, and find out more about them. So that's the ability of a computer to understand images and text. When you take picture of an image of a newspaper cutting, which has so much text, you take a picture of it through Google Lens or Adobe Scan or Office Lens or whatever scanner, then it gives you an option to copy text from image. You can convert the hard copy to soft copy. So that's the ability of the computer to see, understand, interpret, and analyze data from the images. Your face is your, you know, opens your laptop, or it opens your mobile. So that power of computer is called computer vision. Data, we all know that, you know, whatever data we feed into computer, so AI banks on data to a lot, because machine ko seekhne ke liye data chahiye, so it depends on data. And third is natural language processing. Tools like translators, dictate, convert from one language to another, change the, you know, for example, just see it on my screen. I have this Edge browser. So I open any website. Let me go to a website called, let's say this is photosynthesis. I have opened a topic and let me go to this website which comes first. Now, if suppose I click this button, enter immersive reader, first of the thing, AI could analyze the ad part. So ad part is gone. It's a clean website now. Now I use this read aloud feature.
Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process by which
AI is reading for me. I click here. I can change the voice accent to American, Indian, even Hindi, male, female. I have so many voices. I can change that.
PHOTOTROPHS convert light energy into chemical energy, which is later used to fuel.
So it's a typical Hindi Indian lady voice. I have more options, like I can change this page to other languages. So I have reading preferences. So I can, you know, it says that line focus, I can keep the line focus at a time because children should not get distracted. I want them to read line by line. I have picture dictionary available. So for example, if I take my tool to a word for which a picture is available, it will show me the pictures, right? So if I want to translate it to another language, so these are the languages which are given. Hindi teachers would be happy to know that some of the pages are also available in Hindi. Like this is available in Hindi. If I translate and I say translate entire page, so it has been translated to Hindi. So this kind of things are blessings for especially language teachers. For example, you are a French teacher or aapko koi unseen passage nahi mil raha hai, which you want to test and give in your exam, or you teach German, you don't have relevant material, but you have material in English. Fetch that material in English and convert it to German. So AI would do that for you. You have regional languages like Gujarati, Punjabi, you know, Malayali. So there are 20 regional languages. I am not sure which are these. So I see Marathi here, Nepali here, Odia here, Punjabi hai. So suppose I change it to Punjabi. And so this is coming. I think Gurpreet sir can read it and confirm whether it's right or wrong. So these are the powers of natural language processing. So ability of computer to, you know, dictate means I can dictate in multiple languages. Computer can type that for me. Ability of computer to convert into from one language to another. So this is all the power of AI. Now, the last bit of session, which I want to tell you that every AI has is based on ability of machine to learn. And there are three ways in which machines learn. One is supervised, ki aap sikha rahe. Under your supervision, you are training machine that you know what to do. So that is called supervised machine learning. Unsupervised means you are not training the machine, you are giving it data and it is learning from that data. And reinforced learning means you're based on your regular interactions with the machine is learning. Like for example, hum kisi site par 5 bar shopping karne jaate hain, when we go to the 4th or 5th time, our experience becomes better. So maybe for the first time, we would keep hunting where was the size chart, how would it look on me, how can I try. But when I interact with that site many times and I see certain options, I explore, next time AI improves my learning, you know, shopping experience. That kind of AI is reinforced AI. Because of reinforced learning, there are machines through which, you know, people have never won a game of chess. People have never won a game of rock, paper, scissors when they play online. People have never won a game of Ludo. Because with your every interaction with the game, machine is learning. And it is making your life more difficult. It is able to mimic your behavior and understand your mind and judge your next move. And it is moving accordingly. So I will show you just three quick examples of each of these AIs before I close the session. And those three AIs are beautiful. You can use them. You can tell them that children, today we are going to make a machine learning model. And even if they don't know Python, if they don't know anything, they will be able to do that. So here is my first example of supervised learning. I'll just show you the, and I'll give you the link in the chat window. It is called Google Teachable Machine. So you go to Google Teachable Machine. I'm giving the link in the chat window also. So this is a place where we can quickly create with bare minimum knowledge of technology. Also, any subject teacher can make the kids complete machine learning model. So for example, you are here. Once you are here, no need to sign up or do anything. Just say get started. Up there are three kinds of machine learning project: image project, audio or pose project. I would suggest ek main abhi aapko karaungi, baki do aap explore kar sakte hain. In the interest of time, main thoda simple sa le rahi hu, audio one, and to create some humor also. So when you take audio project, first of all, jahan par bhi baith ke aap bana rahe us room mein agar koi background sound hai ya kuch hai, to aapko background sound record karna hai. So I am hitting my mic and letting it record the background sound for 20 seconds. Then I would click on extract sample. I've extracted those samples which AI gathered in 20 seconds. Now my second is, let's say I want to AI to, so maybe I'm making a model, that AI model which help AI to distinguish between a clapping sound, somebody's crying, and somebody is laughing. So clap, cry, and laugh. I want to make a model that segregate all of this. So I'm just taking clap. So I'll click on mic and I will give it samples. I have to give 8 minimum samples. Aap log clap karna chahe to aap bhi kar sakte hain. I'll click on record. So start now. We have got the samples. अब अगले samples के लिए बाबा रामदेव का हम हास्य आसन कर सकते हैं. We can laugh and the AI would record. So I'm just putting a mic. So we can extract. Remember to press extract after every recording. Otherwise we'll overdo our recording. So two more. So once you have recorded, ab mere ko cheekna nahi aata, if anyone would like to cry, so we can make. Otherwise we can just go for these two sound models. Aap aise bahut sare bana sakte hain. Jaise aap bachcho ko bole कि आप एक ऐसा मॉडल बनाओ जो ट्रेन की साउंड, फ्लाइट की साउंड और बस की साउंड में डिस्टिंग्विश करे. और आप अ मॉडल मेक, अ मॉडल विच डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द साउंड ऑफ अ पिकॉक, साउंड ऑफ अ लायन एंड रोर ऑफ, मींस मे बी रोर ऑफ अ लायन एंड रोर ऑफ अ टाइगर, वट एवर. सो यू कैन इंट्रोड्यूस बर्ड साउंड टू देम एंड दे वुड डू रिसर्च, दे वुड फाइंड आउट यू नो साउंड फाइल्स फ्रॉम इंटरनेट एंड देन दे कैन अपलोड. So there is a provision of upload also. So for example, अगर मुझे cry का करना होता, so I would have said cry sound MP3. I can try to find out some from internet, baby cry sound or whatever, and then if I get it for free download, I can upload it over there as samples. So it's male cry sound. So let me just download, and I am downloading 2-3 sounds, female cry sound. So what I can do is, I can upload these samples where it would require 8 samples. So I'm downloading 7-8 samples. I'll come back here on the Google Teachable machine and then I would upload those samples. So I would now upload it here. In the, I can make a new class, add a new class, and its name can be Cry. And then I can upload my samples. So I would go to upload. It says choose audio zip files. You can drag. So I can either upload a zip file, but since I have downloaded all the sounds separately, so what I'll do is I can first put all the download files into one folder and I can zip that, and then I can, you know, actually upload one zip at a time. That will be easier. So these are my voices. I just want to make sure that I have 8. So I'll make a folder with the name Cry. I would put all the sounds that I downloaded just now. I'll move them to this folder. And I'll go to the folder, I'll make a zip out of it. So I'll, how to make a zip, right click and say compress. I can compress it into a, so just let me check if I have the option to send to compressed zipped folder. So I've made a zipped folder out of it. Now I am going to, its name is also Cry. Now I'm going back to my Google Teachable machine. I click on download and I take this Cry zipped folder. So when I do that, I have uploaded that. Mm-hmm. Just one minute. Somehow it is not accepting that. I think that is RAR file and it is, or is it zip file only, no? Yeah, it has come now. I think it is coming by drag and drop. So I just drag and drop it here. I'm just trying one last time. If it happens, otherwise I'll delete this class. Some problem with my, you can only upload zip files with audio data. There is some problem with my zip file. So I'll delete this class in the interest of time, but you can try. So these two, I'm training the model with clap and laugh only. So once you are done, you can add as many classes as you want. And if you have a sample from internet, as I told you, you can upload. Maybe my zip software is giving some problem. Once it is trained, so it would say preparing training data. Aapko training pe click karna hai. It will take 1 or 2 minutes to understand your different kind of sounds. So machine is getting trained in the backend. आप ये जो backslash 50 देख रहे हैं इसका मतलब है 50 times the machine is going through each sound and learning it. Now see, I'll clap. See, while I was clapping, the model was showing clap wala bar. I'm speaking, it is getting confused. Now I laugh. So when I'm laughing, it would show the laugh bar up. Kyunki beech mein main bol bhi rahi hu, so it is getting confused. So this is the simplest example. And I have done it in multiple subjects. Ab jab aap image model banate hain, so for example, if I come back to home page, and if you make image model, to aap, you give this exercise to children. You teach them once how it happens, and then you say that, you have to make an image model which distinguish between carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, fats. So you tell them that a food classifier image, you know, machine learning model banao. You tell them that, you know, make an image learning model which classify between iron, aluminium, steel. So you know, they will do research on internet. They will upload relevant pictures and they will be, see this simple example jo iske ad mein aata hai. There is this girl which has this comes on the ad. This girl has a teddy and she herself. So if she shows teddy, it shows dog. And if she shows herself, it shows me. Now this piano is there. If the piano comes, see, person is making the pose of wings or tree. So these are, you know, some examples, and every subject teacher can use it in your subject. You just have to think what machine learning model you want children to make. It actually gives them liberty to do a lot of research and make the model. So you are actually giving for researching skills also. Now, last two tools which I'm going to tell you, and I'm sure that will make your life easier. Bear with me for 5 more minutes. I'm sure time is going to get over. Sir, can I take 5 more minutes?
I guess, yes, ma'am. And
yes, ma'am.
Yes, Subha.
Yes.
Okay.
Please carry on. We are loving it, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. So there is this AI. If I say you teachers, the AI will make question paper and marking scheme for you. So you have this AI. Now, if you take paid version of it, if you convince your school that we want paid version of it and you spend $5-7 per hour, then your life would be, you know, much more easier. But even if you are working with free version, you can make worksheets simply with some questions. So how does AI work? I've given the link in chat window. You can, you know, sign up for free into this. So I will log in because I already have an account. Now, once you are here, the first thing is you have to type the topic on which you are making a worksheet. Let's say I go back to that.
Sorry, ma'am, to interrupt you in between. I lost the connection. Since it is the last point, could you please repeat it?
Yeah. So, ma'am, I'm hearing my voice back in. So, this particular AI, which I have given you the link, this helps you to make your own question paper. So you go to this AI. In the free version, however, there are some limitations. You sign up to Quizilon.com. But in the free version also, we have the space to do lot many things. Now, since most of the schools use NCERT books, we have the soft copy of the books available. So you go to NCERT website, you know, download the PDF of your book, copy the content and just paste it. So say today I've planned to teach 2 pages of the book. So I go there, I copy the content of those 2 pages and I paste it here. So I'm showing you this, for example, abhi mere paas NCERT book nahi hai. Let's say I go back to this website where I was for photosynthesis and I make it first clean by removing the ads by entering into immersive reader mode. Now suppose I copy this content. So I'm just copying this very content, whatever it is, because I want to make a worksheet out of it. So I go till here. I don't take the questions from the website. I go to Quizilon and I paste this content. So I did control C from there and control V here. There I have taken 1394 words and the minimum word count for making a question paper is 300 words minimum, 3000 words maximum. I would suggest that if you have this fear ki jaise humko ye website pata chali hai, ho sakta hai bachcho ko bhi pata ho. If we make question papers from here, will children not know the answers? So, but you can definitely use it for day-to-day worksheet. How do I use it? If suppose I know that tomorrow I have to teach these 2 pages of NCERT book, I teach in my own way. I never open the book, but I cover the book content and then I paste the content of those 2 books here and get a quick worksheet, which I make them do in the last 5 minutes as a recap activity. That is how I use it. Now you have given the title, you have given the subject, you have pasted your text. Then you say proceed. And now it is processing your content. It is AI's reading. Is this content good enough to make a worksheet? At times AI says that this content looks too low standard to make a good question paper. At times AI say that I need more content. So here it did not prompt me. It means my content is fine. Now it is asking me to select the keywords on which I want questions to be formed. So my keywords based on grade 6, let's say be photosynthesis, chlorophyll, green leaves, light, green plants, light energy. So I can have some keywords. And then I can proceed.
Hi, Vita.
Now there is this something called we have this something called content readiness meter. So content readiness meter tells you how good your content is. It says, great, your content is now perfect for the Quizilon AI engine to process. So AI has given me content readiness meter is 99. My suggestion is whenever it gives you below 85, your question paper will be of less good quality. So it should be 85 and above. Then say get questions and notes idea. Click this button. Now it will start to prepare your worksheet. In the paid version, you even get handouts, you even get lesson plans. So you just give the text to AI, AI does everything, but that is an option available in the premium paid version. In the free version, we can just generate some worksheets. So some schools to whom I have suggested, their management has invested like it's about $8-$10 per year. So they have given to HOD some account and they actually use the AI in a great way. By the time it is happening, I'm giving the link of one AI in the chat window, the last AI for day, which I will show you, and that will also be useful for you all. So now see, my question paper is ready on the screen. There are 23 questions with answer key. I can download them with or without questions. There are options to save, and I can save and export questions to a PDF. You know, I can export questions to a text file, a PDF, a Word file, and then to an open source software. So I can export questions and notes. Notes are available, like it has made its own gist out of the notes. These questions will be available in the paid version, but in the free version, I have some notes and I have question ideas. So you can, you know, actually see if it is of use. I think bio teachers would agree that they are good questions. Now the next AI that I have given you chat in the chat window is called YouClassify. So this AI, if suppose you have done a survey with your parents and you want them to, you know, you want to judge their sentiments ki aapne kaisa raha unko parents ko acha laga ki nahi laga. So I have just one sample you know, feedback form, which I have of previous session. I'm opening that. So I had taken one session last week and I have some feedback. Now what I'm going to do, I did not read that. And I want to unknow the sentiments or mood of my audience. I'll just go to this and copy this section. I have copied this. Now this particular AI helps me to classify sentiments, gender, topics. So aap koi bhi data de sakte hain, languages, mood, there are lot many things and many parameters related to commerce teachers also. So suppose I want to understand the sentiments. Was my audience happy? Were they in a good mood after the session? How was their feedback? Now see, positive 97%, 3% negative. Maybe some people had network issues, they or some felt I was too fast. So they have written like that. So this particular AI helps you to classify your feedback. So when I was dealing with this PPT, I told you that there are three kinds of machine learning. One is supervised. So Google Teachable machine is an example of supervised. We are training the machine. One is unsupervised. So you classify as unsupervised because we are giving data de rahe and it is learning on its own. And the third one is your, which I told you was Quizalon. That is also unsupervised. The example of reinforced is this one, rock, paper, scissors, which you can play with your children and ask them to play when you give them break during online classes. So you have this AI, rock, paper, scissors. I've given the link there also. So you can ask them to play with the machine. And this AI is reinforced AI because whenever we play based on our action, it learns. So it is learning when based on my action. So I understood that how it is doing. Now suppose I'm repeating myself. So AI understood that. So you can show them how it is working in the backend by clicking on this link. How is computer winning and thinking? So this is how this AI works. Now, before I wrap up, a quick recap, because it's always good that you wrap up the session coming back to the objectives. So I think you understood now how AI works, how our results in digital space, our digital footprints give AI more data, how we can AI increase productivity with AI like Quizalon, YouClassify, and you can increase engagement in the classroom by making them do making machine learning models or play with these AIs like Affinity, rock, paper, scissors. So I was to cover this. Sorry for taking 10 minutes extra, but I hope I could add some values and you have some takeaways from the session.
Yes, ma'am. Many, many takeaways. And it was not, you know, it was because of the session starting.